I'm Marilyn Manson. I'm here because my new album, Mechanical Animals, comes out tomorrow. I'm the mark of a new age that I'm trying to make sure happens to bring some life back into rock and roll. I've just finished, as you all know, the MTV Video Music Awards. It wasn't very dominated by rock and roll, but I think that by next year, maybe we'll be back on track and things won't be so geared towards R&B. There'll be a little bit more balance. I think it's been the music industry, along with conservative America, that has followed the era of grunge music and made rock and roll less and less relevant. It's something that I focused on greatly while making this record, and I hope that what I did is something that everyone enjoys, and I'd like to share it with everyone, and that's why I'm here today. So I'm going to talk about the songs and what went into making this record, and what I'm trying to give to the fans with this album.
Daily here. You just saw Marilyn Manson. He has addressed the nation, and now for the first time ever, the nation is going to address him right back. All live right here. We're joined by some of his disciples and detractors. They've swarmed our studio, and we've taken over Times Square to challenge Marilyn. Of course, I'll just be the medium guy. I'm not going to challenge anybody. You guys will have a half an hour right here. It'll be a heated half an hour, sort of a battle of beliefs, if you will. Matt Pinfield is out in Times Square. We're going to check out how the mobs are doing out there in just a little bit. If you guys are at home, you want to get involved, you can. It's 888-311-4343. We are live in New York right now. Now, it's no secret that Marilyn Manson has stirred up some controversy, but if you're not sure why or you're just too embarrassed to ask somebody, have a look at this.
Sick.
Crazy.
Out there.
A person's worth is measured by not only how many people love them, but how many people hate them.
Over the past several years, there's been a marked increase in the number of exceptionally violent.
I think our music is a release of aggression.
Hateful.
I speak about hate and I show the reflection of hate.
Racist.
If I hold up a picture and people call me a racist, then that's what they're feeling inside themselves.
Anti-woman songs that are not only out in the market, but in many cases are topping the charts.
I think our fans are some of the only few intelligent people in America, and everybody else are the ones that are missing the point.
So I think Marilyn Manson is adult entertainment. I don't think teenagers, like under 18, should be there anyway.
We're gonna shut you down because what you propose is not uplifting. It's not helpful. It doesn't advance the culture.
I think if anyone was afraid of what might go on at a Marilyn Manson concert, they should take their kid with them.
Straight from the main stage of this year's Lilith Fair, here's Marilyn Manson!
Creative way to show your ass goes to Marilyn Manson.
People gravitate towards sensationalism, and the media feeds it. And you can either be manipulated by it or you can make it part of your art, and I just try and make it part of what I do.
All right, very nice. You can keep it going. Please welcome Marilyn Manson and his bandmates Twiggy Ramirez and Pogo. Thank you guys for being here. All right. Well, thank you for coming back.
No, thanks.
Actually, last
for
time
everybody
you were here,
showing up again.
You said that you'd come back around the release of the new record. It's nice of you to come back. Twiggy, welcome. Pogo, welcome. Have you had a chance to see back the performance from the Video Music Awards?
Well,
of how it looked on TV?
I saw it live the first time, and it seems like you guys changed it around the second time. So I changed the lyrics a little bit, and we had some special performers on stage, and it seemed like
what, like, a little what, bit give me an example,
a little
what
fear.
Got missed.
Well, the second time around, since there was such a big, silly controversy about saying queers on stage, which wasn't a hateful word, it was just a commentary. So we changed it to fags the second time to make sure. But you guys edited that out. But and we also had the Goddess Bunny, this very amazing performance artist that's in the Dope Show video, whose body is misshapen from birth, but she's an amazing performer. Right. And I think everyone was afraid to show her because she didn't look like everyone else, but I think that's what makes her unique, and that's why we had her on stage.
That's very cool. I'm more interested to know who your dressing room was near backstage, because you're next to these people like Backstreet Boys and Puffy, all these people that we've talked about before. You don't exactly, I'm sure, respect musically. What happened? What was the backstage vibe like?
I was actually upstairs, so I missed the whole thing. But, I learned to respect people on different levels, you know. I think as long as someone's expressing themselves, you know, I can't hate them for it.
Yeah. The Dope Show, we're going to... actually, you know what, let's go back to 1997, to your Video Music Award performance, which we're going to show right here. Obviously drastically different from what we saw. As you look back at this, what do you think? Anything pop in your head?
Well, this morning Howard Stern said that my... ass wasn't as good as it was last year. But
do you agree with that?
You know, maybe for a year, so I'm ready to...
That should mean your ass should be flatter from actually sitting in the studio.
Yeah.
But visually very different, and we'll take a look.
Absolutely
right now.
Absolutely very different. Antichrist Superstar was a very pointed album, and it was a body of work that kind of represented the transformation that I went through from childhood till now. And it was a lot of more of an angry record. And the result of that is Mechanical Animals. You know, that record changed me. Writing that book changed me. And now I have a different look on life. The numbness wore off. And now I'm starting to feel things on a different level.
Right.
So it's a different kind of record.
And great, mind you. We've listened to it. It comes out tomorrow. Paul Hunter directed the video for The Dope Show. This is sort of the public's first chance to take a look at your new image. Heritage R&B video director, primarily with Boyz II Men, Missy Elliott, Mariah. Paul's on the phone, actually. Paul, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here. What's up, guys?
How's it going, Paul?
How you doing, Manson?
Good.
It's funny, too, because some people call you Marilyn, some people call you Manson. Paul, do you have any reason why you refer to him as Manson, quickly?
I like the way it sounds.
Paul, how did you come to work with Marilyn Manson? How did this thing start with The Dope Show?
It was funny because I've been wanting to work with him for a while, and he actually reached out to me. I was at my production office, and I was listening to the record, and he reached out to me, and we talked and got together.
Did you pitch a treatment, or Marilyn, did you have an idea of what you wanted? This is a very important video.
We collaborated. It was a very strong collaboration.
It's Billy Zane, isn't it?
Yes.
Titanic?
What I liked about Paul is that he has a sense of greatness. Because sadly, rock music lacks a lot of creativity right now. And R&B has more creativity. And Paul's videos are all very exciting. And I wanted someone who could take the metaphor of what The Dope Show's about, the alienation of rock stardom, the alienation of drug use, Hollywood, and to make that into something like this, and I'm very, very pleased with what he did.
Will you work with Paul again?
Absolutely.
All right, very cool. And a great job, too. Great colors. Thanks. Paul, thank you for calling in. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thanks,
all
Paul.
Right, we're going to take a break. Up next, the audience is going to have their way with Marilyn Manson, ask some questions about the new record, Mechanical Animals, and anything else they want to ask him. We'll be right back with more Manson TV on MTV.
Pretty, pretty. understanding.
All right, Marilyn Manson taking over New York. All in anticipation of the release of the fourth record, Mechanical Animals, tomorrow. Oh, there's the crowd outside. Yeah, whose kid is that? That's crazy. Coming to a Manson event with your son? Oh, it's nuts. Marilyn Manson, Twiggy Ramirez and Pogo joining us here, and a group of people, a very diverse group in the room. What do you think of the setting of this room? I actually walked in and thought that one of these mannequins was you.
I did too for a second. I was going to have sex with
it. It's like one of those real dolls.
This is like kind of like the Springer show, it looks like. I'm ready for it.
Yeah.
Like
it. Well, mm-hmm.
Not in a bad way. I like the Springer show.
Nothing's flown across the room yet.
But fight, maybe.
You're right. We've got ourselves in this band, in this group, Christian Rockstar, some diehard groupies, and editor of a very popular Marilyn Manson website, the youth pastor. We're going to take some questions from them now, starting off with Evan Moore, who I believe is in charge of the website. Evan, where are you? Evan, how are you?
I'm fine, fine.
You have a microphone, Evan? I can hardly hear you.
Yeah, I got a mic.
Okay, good.
Your new album, Mechanical Animals, due out tomorrow, symbolizes a lot about drugs, and even in the booklet itself. Do you feel that the media will associate your album with drugs a lot more than usual?
Well, the album has to do with drugs is often used as a metaphor besides the obvious term. And while writing it and after going through the transformation of Antichrist Superstar, I began to feel again emotions for the first time, strangely enough. And the more I began to feel, the more and more the world started to look like mechanical animals. And that was the theme that started running through that. And I was kind of studying in my life and in other people around me, and particularly in Hollywood, how we numb ourselves and make ourselves less human and more mechanical. And I mean, if they want to attach to the drug thing, I mean, that's fine. I mean, that's been part of my life. You know, it's not something that I hide or deny.
What do you attribute that sort of feeling again?
It's probably worse than what I felt last year. You know, I think I put myself through a lot of physical pain to make up for no emotional pain.
Yeah.
And that's what a lot of people told me, kind of in retrospect. Is that when I moved to Hollywood a year ago, I started to repair myself in a lot of ways. And this record lyrically documents that repair.
Jeff Hamilton is here, an actual youth pastor. Jeff, what's your question for Marilyn?
Actually, one of the things that I admire about this whole process has been your transparency from early interviews through these albums, the book. And you're talking about metaphors being in this particular album and a return to realness and feeling in your life. What does that cost you then, emotionally? What does that cost you relationally to move from that place of numbness to a place of feeling and interaction and processing with people and in your life?
That's a long question.
Sorry. Well, strangely enough, it's a lot harder than I thought it was going to be. You know, I set out to be something superhuman, something the greatest thing I could be with Antichrist Superstar, and what I didn't figure into that was vulnerability was a part of it, and that was something that I was not acknowledging. You know, I didn't want to feel. Now that I am, I'm sure everybody's been through it, you know. I mean, it's what life is, and
it's crazy. People love you now.
It's like being—it's like a rebirth. It's like being an infant. Everything's bright. Everything's very painful, and so in some ways, I've gotten back my innocence that I was looking for. You know,
you get some breasts, and everybody loves you.
You can't hate them.
Yeah, hell no. Especially yours. You look better than anybody else's. Mechanical Animals also sort of seems like it would entail these people who do follow, and now that you're sort of aware of that. It's interesting because we have some diehard fans, Allison and Jeanette, is it, here, who have carved Marilyn Manson, and I'm sure you've met them before.
Yeah, they're friends of mine.
So how do you take to someone who would follow you to the point of self-mutilation? Is that sort of contradicting your own message of this don't follow the status quo?
It depends, because I can't say exactly what they're thinking, but to me, when I look at them and I consider them friends, it's their way of identifying, you know, their way of being a part of something, because the rest of the world has shut them off in some way. And it's their way of expressing themselves, and I'm not one to judge how people express themselves.
Right. This is going way too nice. Is there anybody here who's not a fan? Anybody have the balls to say that? You're right here with them. Not you, Pogo.
Yes, my name is Rob Hayes. I'm a senior at Princeton University, and I'm also the president of Campus Crusade for Christ there on campus. I'd have to say I'm not necessarily a fan of your whole message, but again, this was something that I found interesting, is that if in my own intellectual pursuits, I find myself and happiness and joy in being a Christian, yet you preach that, you know, there is no God and that God does not exist. Is that hypocritical?
That's half true. You know, I'm more
if I define
against the guilt that Christianity imposes, but I think that God exists in art, and there's more spirituality in music than you can find in religion a lot of times. But I'm not one to condemn anyone's pursuit of God or happiness or anything like that. I just think that we're raised to feel very guilty for being ourselves, and that's a large part of what Christianity stands for. But I think there's great and valuable things in the Bible. If anything, Antichrist Superstar was a lot of parallels with my life with someone like Lucifer. Mechanical Animals has a lot more parallels between me and Jesus Christ. So, you know, I've found a different way to relate to things. But that doesn't mean that I'm going to be a born-again Christian. It just means that I can find some valid points in your religion. I don't think that everything about it is wrong.
That's been a huge misconception, too, since day one. People thought that you were out there, like, protesting Sunday school. You've never done that.
I kicked a Sunday school teacher. Actually, when I was in...
Who hasn't?
When I was in Christian school, I had these things made out of a ruler and a rubber band with crayons, and we were shooting them at each other, and the principal's wife, who was the Bible teacher, I had it under my desk, and I accidentally shot her in the crotch. And so I have reacted violently towards those sort of authorities.
Hence the song Reflecting God, probably. Great song that I miss, actually. All right, we're going to take a break. When we get back, we're going to check with Matt Pinfield, who you can hear the crowd out there in Times Square. We'll check in with them, talk about some of the symbolism, too, of the new record, Mechanical Animals, out tomorrow. More with Marilyn Manson.
Those cops have the wrong color
uniforms get back.
On them.
Yes, they do. They should be clean.
Strange things are happening in Times Square. Surprising things, big things, music things. MTV's back in our Times Square studio, weekdays. And it's gonna be strange, surprising, big, and full of music. Catch the lineup starting with Total Request live at 3:30, Real World Theater at 4:30, and Jam's Countdown at 5:30. Weekdays on MTV. Times Square will never be the same again.
I want to stay in the jungle.
If you're one of the millions of Americans who suffer from the emotional pain of having genital warts, you might have them burned off, frozen off, or cut off. Or you could treat them with a prescription cream, Aldara. Aldara cream is clinically proven to treat external genital warts conveniently and effectively. You use Aldara cream in the privacy of your own home. And few people who used Aldara cream complained of pain. Aldara cream treats external genital warts, but is not a cure. The most common side effects are redness, peeling, and itching in the wart area. The effect of Aldara cream on the spread of genital warts to partners is unknown, and sexual contact should be avoided while the cream is on the skin. For a free information packet about Aldara cream, call 1-800-831-7932. Help take the suffering out of genital warts. Ask your doctor about Aldara cream.
She cooked for you. She cleaned for you. She cared for you.
Mother! Oh, God! Mother!
When was the last time you called your mother? Psycho, a new film from Gus Van Sant. This film is not yet rated.
I guess I didn't know.
Of GoldenEye, Kobe Bryant in NBA Courtside, the WCW versus NWO, or Diddy Kong Racing for new additions to the Player's Choice Library for just $39.95. Don't miss it.
Research showed that creatine increased muscle performance by over 8%. And now during GNC's Sports Nutrition Sale, you can pick up a kilo of Pro Performance Creatine for only $49.99. Live strong, live well.
His life was looking up till his best friend got in trouble with the mob. Now he's got to risk everything to save him.
Can I count on you?
You can always count on me, Mike.
Matt Damon, Edward Norton, Gretchen Mol, Rounders, rated R. Now playing in theaters everywhere.
When I saw the Doors, I was ashamed not to go out immediately the next day and do your own gig, you know? It was a beautiful performance by an extremely stoned human creature. He had sort of Hedy Lamarr curls, a leatherette ensemble with a big fluffy shirt, and he came out at a University of Michigan homecoming dance on a stage only about 18 inches high, and he refused to sing any of the songs in a normal voice. So, you know, instead of singing like, "The clock says it's time to close now," he'd sing, "The clock says it's time." And he sort of just wandered the stage like a drunk, right? And it pissed these, "Hey, you know, I'm the captain of the football team here, and we paid for this, and we're going to get your ass." You know, there was a real heavy question of, can you antagonize us this much and get away with it? I loved it. I was totally, yeah.
Such a diverse crowd now, and now it looks like, it's like golf. We're back on MTV, Manson TV. Golf used to just be like old white guys, and now since Tiger Woods, it's just this broad group. The last time you were here,
don't talk to me about sports.
I know that. I'm not going, I'm making a metaphor here, I'm making an analogy. Now, like, everybody's coming out to see you. Like, the little kid.
That infant.
Cops.
Yeah.
They love you.
Queers.
All of them. We're back. Trigger Mirror's Pogo over here as well. We're going to go right out to Matt Pinfield, who's out there.
Love everybody.
Amongst the crowd. Matt?
Thanks a lot, Carson. How you doing? We're here with this amazing amount of fans in Times Square for Marilyn Manson. Excited about him being here. Michael, you wanted to ask Marilyn a question. What is it?
Marilyn, when you become president, who's going to be the first person to give you oral sex in the White House?
Twiggy.
Won't that be a joyous day?
You know, the president's staying across the street from our hotel. I think that we're going to go over there and see if he's...
Are you really?
I got a cigar.
I'll have to give him oral sex.
We'll give him oral sex. Why not?
Yeah, what the hell? Take a DV cam and tape it for us. Thank you, Matt.
All right, Carson. All right, thanks.
All right, where's Aaron as a Christian artist who's here? How's it going? What's your question for Mary?
Are you from Striper? Striper's awesome.
Those guys from Striper do drugs.
I did drugs with the guys from Striper.
Yeah.
Those guys are
the
most.
What are you guys are doing?
Nah, man.
Striper's our biggest influence.
It wasn't for you guys.
It wasn't for Striper.
I don't think Aaron's
the most
Striper.
Satanic band ever.
But these works for you represent Striper.
No,
I'm Aaron, what you in? Like, you guys lump me in.
What's your question?
I saw your new record, that a symbol of Omega, a lot on there. And I noticed that you alluded to yourself as an Omega or whatever. And all I know of the Omega is that God said he's the Alpha and the Omega. What do you mean by that when you say that?
Very biblical references.
Yeah, biblical.
There's a lot of biblical references still on this record and a lot of numerological references too, but the Omega symbol kind of represents the final stage of what was set forth on Antichrist Superstar. So this is kind of the final evolution of whatever
before
it is that I am.
Kind of a thing.
Yeah. But again, there is some allusions to Christ as well in this record. Yeah, it's looking at things from a flip side.
Wait, we've got another question over there.
I'm sorry.
Go ahead,
your
man.
Your image has always gone through like these changes, and obviously God through art is something very personal to you. I was wondering, do you see your art going a certain direction? Is it more spontaneous? Like, can you foresee some of the changes that might come in like the next 2 years? Or is it just something that comes within on like a...
Well, I think we've really grown as a band, and we're kind of looking at this record as a new beginning, some, you know, a starting point. A lot of people would think that Antichrist Superstar was the most that we could do. This was our pinnacle, but it's really just the beginning for us, and it's hard to say. I think we're just going to always kind of evolve. All right. I'm inspired by what I see around me.
We're going to go right over to Gene. Gene?
Great.
You have a mic? Okay.
Oh, yeah. I love your new look. It totally is great.
Thanks,
like, it's everything about indulgence and glitter glam. I'm so glad it's back and you guys are bringing it back. But regarding, like, numerology, you were talking about that. Your new font is, like, using a 1 and a 5, and then the release date's the 15th, and there allegedly are 15 tracks on the album. Can you elaborate on...
It's also January 5th is my birthday. I'm going to be 30 this year. That's half of my age.
Wow. And we, the address of MTV is 1515 Broadway. Huh?
The number Marilyn Manson also equals 6. There's a lot of different things, but if you look for coincidences, you know, you'll start realizing that there are no such thing as coincidences, that everything has a purpose.
Well, that's what I figure.
I just have a follow-up to what
Hold
this
on,
guy
there's
Gene
people
said.
Yelling out here. It is a Springer show, for crying out loud.
Hey.
Wait, make this quick, because we don't have much time.
I just have like a follow-up to what this guy was saying. I mean, you know, I respect you guys. I think it's great. You're having your big day and all that, but there are tons of bands that have been doing this whole glitter glam thing way before Manson ever came onto the scene.
Been.
Yeah, and I respect these guys. I'm glad they're making it, but it's like this whole rock star thing today is not about unity, and it kind of sucks, because there's a lot of awesome bands, and there's no more unity anymore. Instead, it's just this selfish, like, you know, like empire, you know, for each. It's
all right. That's all I have time for.
I don't think that they're, you know, I would lend a hand to any band that I saw putting as much effort into what they do as what we do, you know. And I've always had underground bands come on tour with us, and you know, that's what rock stardom is about, is about self-preservation, you know. If anybody wants to be a rock star, they've got to try hard enough. You know, they're not going to get it handed to them.
And you got
to
look good doing it, that's for sure. We're out of time.
You
know, hold on, we'll chat off there. You look good, brother. Go for yours.
Artist and performance artist. I want to know who's your fashion designer. That's what I want to know.
Don't we want to know that?
That's all the time we have. Thank you. We'll continue this.
As long as you wear that
Virgin
Megastore
in New York, you can check out that we're doing a signing. Mechanical Animals comes out tomorrow. Thank you for being here. Appreciate it. Marilyn Manson, Trigger Ramirez from Pogo. Thanks for watching Manson TV. Go on.